Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to another Sunday morning old cookbook show. And today we're going to do a recipe out of The Art of Cooking and Serving with 549 tested Crisco recipes. This was published in 1936 by the Procter & Gamble Company, who owned Crisco at the time. And I find it to be a very interesting cookbook from a social standpoint. The recipes are very interesting too, but it really touches on how society was changing in the 1930s and how it was changing during the Great Depression. So the first chapter in this cookbook is how to manage table service in a household where you've lost your servant. And then the second chapter in the cookbook is all about how to train a new servant if you happen to get a new maid, and what they should wear and how they should wear their uniform and what, you know, all the trends are for the uniforms in your servant and what they should know. And I find that to be a very interesting juxtaposition with the social changes that are happening outside in the 1930s. The recipe that we're going to do today is called Cobblestone Pie. And it's on a page with three apple pie recipes. One sort of the traditional apple pie that everybody knows and loves, two crust apple pie. The other is a one crust apple pie, which is essentially a take on the classic French tartatin. And then this one, it's called a cobblestone pie. And I've never had an apple pie where the apples are treated this way. So I thought it'd be quite interesting to give it a shot. I'm going to start out by peeling the apples. And you could use a paring knife or you could use a potato peeler. Sometimes a potato peeler is a little bit easier. The next instruction is to cut the apples in quarters and then core them. Next, I have to arrange the apples in an unbaked pie shell. Now, I have Crisco out on the counter because it calls for Crisco later in the recipe. I didn't use Crisco in my pie shell. I am not a huge fan of pie shells made with vegetable shortening. It's just not my thing. I prefer all butter, which this one is, and I'll link or try to remember to link to a recipe for that crust below. Or I prefer lard, all pure lard as a pie crust, pork lard. That's the pie crust that I grew up with, the pork lard pie crust. I never quite took to shortening. I don't know why. But I've got it out here because I have to dollop on some Crisco later in the recipe. The other thing is, what's in this can today, 2020, has little to do with what's in Crisco in this cookbook. In the intervening years, the formula has changed so many times that it's just not the same thing. Even by 1936, when this was written, the formula for Crisco was not like the formula for Crisco was at the beginning in the early 1900s. 1911, I think, Crisco came to the market. And so I'm going to cut up a few of the pieces just so that I can jam them in here, get them in really nicely. Now I pour the sugar over top. And it seems like a lot of sugar to me. But who knows? We'll see what happens for the pie. Okay. Wow. Okay, that's a lot of sugar. Now it says to dot with Crisco. And it doesn't really say how much. Dot with small bits of Crisco. A total of 1 tablespoon. So not a whole lot. Very little. Now, like I said, when Crisco was first formulated, the name stood for crystallized cottonseed oil. It hasn't been made with cottonseed oil in a very long time. And this one is a mix of soybean oil and palm oil. Oh boy. Little clumps everywhere of Crisco. Now I'm sure you could just use butter. If Crisco isn't to your liking, I would go ahead and use butter for this. I think butter would have a better flavor, but that's maybe just me. Next, sprinkle on some cinnamon. Not too much. There's only about 1/8 teaspoon of cinnamon. And then some nutmeg. Now it says to bake this for 10 minutes in a quick oven and then reduce the temperature to a moderate oven and go 20 minutes more. So let's see how it turns out.
I got the forks, Glen. I'll stand on this side.
Okay. Now.
Hi, friends.
That's really runny.
Yes.
That might need a bowl.
So, there was nothing in it to thicken the pie. So it's really liquidy in the bottom. The apples didn't break down at all. So they stayed like cobblestones. True to its name, it's cobblestone apple pie.
That might be your apple choice, though.
Might be the apple choice. That's true.
Right? I'm fascinated by the layer on top.
The layer of Crisco.
Is
on, yeah, so there's a congealed layer of Crisco on top of a layer of apple water and sugar.
Okay, so visually it's not working.
Not working.
We're
at
anticipating
all.
A complete disaster. It's definitely going to be messy getting out, so I'm going to help out a little here.
It's impossible to get out because it's so liquidy and there's nothing to trap the liquid. I'm not going to get this piece of pie out. I'm going to say right now, the thumbnail is not a beauty shot of the end piece of pie. It's probably us laughing at how horrible this is. Now, almost.
Oh, and then I didn't help.
Okay. I'm going to say that piece of apple belongs over there. I'm going to say the two other apple pies on this page are probably better.
Okay. Well, I'm going to start with the apple.
Sweet cinnamony apple.
Baked apple.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
The pie crust is only underneath. It's not really cooked very well because there was so much liquid and there was nothing put in to thicken it.
Tastes like crust. It's not stellar crust. It's hard and...
Because it didn't cook properly.
Yeah. It's not flaky in any way.
I would put down a layer of flour on the bottom before you put the apples in.
Or tapioca or...
Minute tapioca is my favorite thing to put in a pie as a thickener because it gels up really nicely.
Mm-hmm.
And it gives you this really luscious feel. It does taste amazing because apples and pastry and sugar and cinnamon and nutmeg, you cannot go wrong. Visually, it's horrible and it doesn't serve very well.
No, I think this is going to be scrambled pie with ice cream. And that's the only way to...
Ice cream makes everything
that's
better.
That's kind of, yeah. Just accept it for what it is.
So, cobblestone pie from the Crisco cookbook needs some work.
Which is actually just one ingredient.
Yeah. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.